This series is ultra important for both of them if they want to have any chance of qualifying.
Yep. And most certainly will be an exciting match. We can see the Twitch poll now live. Looks like Super Rejects are your favorites for today. What? There's no love for Dilly? Does nobody out there love Dilly? I need more hashtag KA.
There's 28%. What do you mean nobody?
I need more.
30% of people that have love for Dilly in this matchup. Envious, though, going to be taking a whole bunch of pressure very early on. Casca's Angels looking to get aggressive with the trap on Akolo. Are they going to be able to force the bubble coming in from Envious right away? It looks like Cyfox is going to get life grip to safety by Milkman. Nicely done using that Archangel to sort of deflect some of this incoming damage from the Super Rejects.
Ooh, Chaos Bolt flying towards Dilly. Envious and Thugonomics also dipping low. Akolo recovering now, though, with a huge healing wave. Bursting Shot, no freezing trap just yet. Envious is crucial. Crusade is starting to max out, potentially massive damage here shortly. Chaos Bolt's being casted by Thugonomics. Dilly trying to hide behind the pillar, but one does go straight to the face. Thugonomics not able to find a second, however, which means Dilly should be able to recover. Mana starting to build a lead for Akolo. The damage from Envious and Thugonomics is massive with Dilly and Cyfox is both below half. Survival Instincts gets traded out. Dilly's trying to move across the map, but if he pushes too far at the wrong time, Envious and a Chaos Bolt could catch his face. Thugonomics looking for one with Soul Harvest. This next Chaos Bolt from Thugonomics could be massive. Cyfoxy delays it by a few seconds, but Soul Harvest is still activated. If Thugonomics can get a Chaos Bolt off, it will be devastating. He's not able to find it, though. Now Envious is on the back foot.
Yeah, almost bubble getting forced out there. Cola doing a good job with the heals, has the Ascendance up, just spamming out the healing waves. Actually, he's dogpiling with his team, making sure Envious and Thugonomics are there to support Dilly. In the meantime, in the middle of the map, Chaos Bolt hits by Thugonomics. Milkman already down to around 50% mana, so obviously the pressure coming in from Super Rejects is super high. You can see Milkman taking a very defensive position, doesn't want to push in for any fears or anything like that. Just trying to keep his team stable so they can stay aggressive.
All right, Thugonomics just lobbing out more Chaos Bolts. Envious going after Dilly, actually using the Hammer of Justice defensively. Milkman positioned very far away. Difficult for Envious to get there to Hammer of Justice and get back to the target. So instead, Hammer of Justice gets dispelled and costs mana. And ultimately, that's what they're trying to win off of, is running Milkman out of mana. Double Mortal Coil, Chaos Bolts being casted by Thugonomics straight for Cyfoxy. He ducks into bear form, trying to soak up some of the pressure. Dilly building up more counter aggression. Akolo in the middle of the map. He's very susceptible to crowd control with where he's positioned right now. He's way too close to Cyfoxy. Cyfoxy moving over for the stun now, but what? He's just gonna die. I guess standing in the middle of the map is okay when you've got Thugonomics on your team. He just needs the damage to find the kill.
But we see this from Akolo constantly with this composition, where he doesn't want to be behind a pillar. He just wants to be there with his Rhett, not line of sight of him, be there with Thugonomics. So basically no one can line of sight. If he's at a pillar, when Cyfoxy goes to get that crowd control, maybe that's the LOS he needs to survive some Chaos Bolt coming in from Thugonomics. So just standing in the middle of the map is an optimal position.
Yeah, and I mean, this composition is really annoying for the jungle to deal with, because they have to go after the Rhett, because the Rhett has that Divine Shield on a 4-minute cooldown. But at the same time, when they do that, I mean, just look at Thugonomics. He's basically forcing the team of Casca's Angels to go on him, because he is standing in the middle of the map, just spamming fears onto everybody. And then when he does get those big Chaos Bolts connecting, I mean, that's good night. And I think Milkman there and Cyfoxy weren't really on the same page there. Milkman still had that pain suppression. If he could get it out a little bit sooner, he could have negated the damage of that Chaos Bolt and potentially saved Cyfoxy in that situation.
Yeah, Milkman trying to get that pain suppression off basically on the corpse of Cyfoxy just a little bit too late, and that's like the worst feeling in the world as a healer, where you have that big cooldown.
I know how that feels with none Rookie on my team.
Yeah, I know. Happens all the time.
Everyone on this desk does.
Yeah. It's a nightmare. Definitely don't want to be in that position. Learn from Nunruki, Milkman. But yeah, interesting start to the series. Super Rejects, of course, is going to take game number one. Now, keep in mind, Casca's Angels, they have to win this series if they want any chance whatsoever. If they get eliminated here, there's absolutely 0% chance that they can make it to the summer finals. So they're going to have to strike back. Of course, it is going to be their map selection as well as their comp selection. I think it's most likely going to be that jungle cleave.
Yeah, the jungle is probably going to select something like Ruins of Lordaeron, maybe even Blade's Edge, one of the smaller maps, I think, where they can kind of do the hit-and-run strategy a little bit better. Naggron, of course, very large map. You have this side, and every time you try to cross to Kolo's side, you are going to get spam-feared by Thugonomics, and he's going to make it very difficult for you to do anything, more or less. One thing I want to criticize Casca's Angels for is that Milkman is typically very defensive. He always stays back at the pillar, and he doesn't really assist too much. And I feel like the best way to kind of get those big CC chains rolling is if he can land a mind control or a fear on the Thugonomics when Dilly and Psyfoxy are pushing in for that crowd control with the trap and the damage onto the Rhett.
Well, the Rhett's also using the Sanctuary on the Bashes and the off memes, right? If he can push in and land a fear, that's going to be that additional crowd control they need to get the bubble from Envious when he's sitting at around 20% HP. So maybe a little bit more of an aggressive play from Milkman could ultimately get them a victory.
At the same time, though, Tokenomics, I believe, is running the Imp pet, which means the spell magic, which Freezing Trap and both Psychic Scream are, so he can remove those long crowd control effects. Then Envious, the Rhett Paladin, can also remove the stun and the fear. So with two partners able to remove crowd control, it seems difficult to ever really get into a position where you can lock Kolo out of the fight long enough to kill a target. So that might be where they're sitting. They're like, okay, well, if we crowd control him, he's just going to dispel it, and I'm in the middle of the map now, and there's a Warlock. I don't want to be there. So I'm going to sit back here. I hope you do enough damage that he dies, because I don't know what we can do from this position. Maybe win off Wyvern Stings, but even then, Envious can dispel poisons. So basically, this composition is just built to remove all the crowd control.
It seems bulletproof.
Exactly.
It seems jungle-proof. I should
jungle
say.
Proof.
Yeah,
they've got the jungle
book. It wasn't a good pun.
They got the bear spray.
Yeah. They got the bear spray. All right. Well, I mean, the Super Rejects, they seem to have their plan nailed down with this composition. It seems to be super effective against the Casca's Angels. Again, a pun I was not intending to play off of.
Yeah, the Super Rejects figured out a super strategy, which is super effective against Casca's Angels. Jungle Cleave. Casca's Angels, once again, they're going to be locking in the Discipline Priest jungle. I kind of wonder, maybe Casca would be better. Sometimes we do see him come in on the Wrestle Shaman. I play the Wrestle Shaman jungle because, Milkman on the Discipline Priest, really not going to be able to assist too much with the Imp Dispels, with that Blessing of Sanctuary. Super Rejects seem to have built essentially almost a perfect comp against jungle, it seems like.
Yeah, maybe they can bring in Casca and try to dampen by training Thugonomics. You have Wind Shear, you can play Voodoo Totem, you're going to have your Feral Druid's Kick and all these stuns, and you're going to have your Hunter as well. And if they can use everything on Thugonomics, maybe they can win with a Mana Lead that way, because it's a Shaman versus a Shaman matchup. So hey, it comes down to just shutting down Thugonomics casts and doing more damage than the Rhett, essentially. So that could be an option. I think another option could be that Milkman just plays more aggressive, tries to get those fears maybe on the Imp or the Warlock, and kind of force Thugonomics in a situation where he has to pick what to dispel. If he dispels a fear, maybe they can get a full trap out of that when he doesn't have the dispel, things like that.
I think that they should play more aggressive and even just target down the Warlock's pet. If they can kill the Imp, it can't dispel if it's dead, and Thugonomics has to spend an extended amount of time trying to get it back, and as Destruction, you don't have portals, so you're stuck in one spot. It's not like he's going to sneak away and resummon the Imp. So I think if Casca's Angels can focus more damage, maybe not even cleave on the Rhett, just hit the pet and the Warlock, single target the Warlock, they could potentially sneak away with this. Because there's no counterspell, Milkman can free cast, which means he can do a lot of damage. He's going to get every Smite, every Penance, every Light's Wrath, without having to worry about getting interrupted. So I would like to see Casca's Angels take a page out of Reform's book, I think, in this matchup and just get aggressive.
Yeah, get very aggressive on that pet. Force Thugonomics sort of into a defensive position. Envious can be the target of choice very early on. Thugonomics looking for the Chaos Bolt. Dilly ducks out of line of sight, though. There's a full bash on Nicole. He's playing the Relentless, so all the CC is going to be a little bit reduced on him. Blessing of Sanctuary forced out by Envious as well. In the meantime, Psyfoxy taking a little bit of damage here. Polo into the Bursting Shot, but now finally out of that crowd control, should be able to stabilize Envious.
All right, Dilly's just taking a lot of damage. Thugonomics lining up a Chaos Bolt off the back of the Mortal Coil. Gets silenced right at the last second. The Dispel from Envious, 1 second, two off, and Thugonomics does not connect the Burst. He is now falling behind. He's trying to banish the Shadow Fiend there, prevent some mana regeneration as Super Rejects are looking to just attrition their opponents. Kolo standing on top of the team to try and soak up a trap, maybe get a Bursting Shot to remove the bleeds, but nice! Dilly snipes the Bursting Shot without hitting the DPS targets. Unfortunately, now it does follow it up with the full trap, but Imp dispels Kolo out of that, completely breaking up the chain, and now Psyfox is overextended. Thugonomics is just waiting to line up the Chaos Bolt, moving over to potentially fear Milkman. Milkman ducks out of line of sight to avoid it. Good avoidance from Milkman, but mana inevitably, I think, in favor of Super Rejects.
Yeah, Envious still at 50% HP. Kolo looking for the heals. Milkman actually in a position to maybe go for a fear. Look at him. He's very close to Kolo. He could use that pillar, but just wants to keep the heals up. Doesn't want to fall behind as Psyfoxy gets lower and lower with the full fear onto Dilly. Archangel gets traded out by Milkman, trying to top off his team, but Psyfoxy runs out of line of sight. Now forced into bear form, forced to retreat behind the pillar. Looking to get aggressive now, but Thugonomics instantly shuts it down with the double Chaos Bolt. Now Dilly almost getting one shot, ultimately does get one shot, taken down. tries to push in for the trap and just gets punished immediately. I think he trinketed out of the coil into a full Hammer of Justice, and that is all the time that Super Frogs or Super Rejects needed.
And that comes down a little bit to Cyfoxy as well, because Cyfoxy, he maimed the Chaos Bolt cast from Thugonomics, but it was a tiny, tiny second too late, and it got off, and of course it was a Chaos Bolt with Dark Soul and Thugonomics. We know him for his beefy Chaos Bolts. He loves the big Chaos Bolts, and he's going to connect that and take about half of Dilly's health away, and then Envy is going to have an easy time finishing Dilly off, and we can take a look at it right here. So there's Cyfoxy using his kick, so that's going to be on cooldown right now. Cyfoxy is going to line of sight a little bit here, and he's going to get topped off. Dilly pushes in, trinkets the Mortal Coil right there, and then there it is. Maim as the Chaos Bolt goes off, and then Envious, of course, with that Hammer of Justice, is going to prevent Dilly from using that aspect of the turtle and take him down.
Just going from 60% HP to 5% HP in a split second. Milkman was there, unfortunately being brought to the other side of that pillar by Cyfoxy. And now this is a very good position for Super Rejects to be in. It seems like they really... they can basically do whatever they want in this matchup. Anyone that pushes in onto Kolo, they're able to immediately punish him. Because Kolo's in the middle of the map, there's nowhere where you can really go. It's a horrible situation. Dillypoof, he just sits out in the open and tries to build up pressure that way. Gonna lose. Pushes in for CC. Seems like they're gonna lose. So I don't know what Casca's Angels can really do.
I would like to see them substitute, I think, Casca in and just play defensive and maybe just attack the Rhett, move around the map, and try and drag the game out to a later point. Early game, they're not going to win, it seems like, at least is what they're trying to do. The other option is that they try to focus on killing the Imp. It's very low health pet. Like, it's not difficult to kill off, but unfortunately, it means you'll have to probably sacrifice damage on a different target, so you're not going to be attacking the Rhett. You won't get any momentum there, but at least you'll get your crowd control, because without the crowd control, what is jungle? It's not really much. So I really think they need to change the targeting up and focus on the Warlock's Imp and the Warlock rather than the Rep Held and then the Warlock and leaving the Imp open. If they do that, I think there's at least some glimmer of opportunity. Otherwise, they can just remove crowd control. They can bait them into bad positions and kill them.
I just want to say, on behalf of all the Arcane Mages out there, we have all died to jungle without CC on our healers.
Okay. So, maybe it's still scary, yeah.
It's still jungle. Let's not brush that off. But yeah, I agree with you. They could bring in Casca and just try to shut down Thugonomics, get some damage rolling, maybe on the Rhett, have some off bleeds on Thugonomics, or the other way around, and try to play that long game. If they want to play with the Discipline Priest, they really, really need Milkman to be in there pushing in with them. Milkman has to go in there, get a fear on the pet, or get just a double fear. It really just opens up everything for the jungle to get those clean setups. And I mean, Dilly's got to go for more Wyvern Stings as well over the freezing trap, because it's just getting this.
Well, he can't. The Rep Paladin can just remove it.
Yeah, but you can stun the Rep.
If they cross a little bit better. If they cross crowd control the Rhett at the same time, although Rep Paladin also has a lot of ways to get out of crowd control.
Yeah, that's why Milkman needs to go in there, control the mind of the Rhett, control it, proc the Ashbringer trinket, and then after that...
Are you getting ready for some LARPing? Just mind control the Warlock?
Yeah, why not? I just want to see Milkman press mind control, honestly. I don't even care if it's on the Rhett, Warlock,
just anyone.
Bat, anyone.
Yeah, throw it on the pet, whatever.
Anything.
It really feels like Casca's Angels, they need to switch it up, and I think maybe like a snowball strategy where you push in, you get that CC. At this point, it really feels like the strat they have is they're essentially just waiting to lose.
Yeah. It really does feel that way. So I would like to see Casca's Angels step it up, get aggressive, either kill the pet and the Warlock, or get in, cross crowd control the Rhett, switch over to Wyvern Sting. Regardless, Casca's Angels need to change their strategy, and it's going to be a risky thing to do because ultimately they're on match point and they're not going to be going to the Summer Finals if they lose this.
Yeah, this is a super important series for Super Rejects. Looking to close this series out 3-0. Casca's Angels, Tournament Live, and Summer Finals hopes and dreams on the line as well. As they charge forward, Dilly going to be looking for that Wyvern Sting onto Envious right away, procking that Rhett Trinket. There's a full trap on Kolo as they put most of the pressure over on Thugonomics, but he should be able to survive. Very tanky is that Destro Warlock.
Oh, Chaos Bolt in the Hammer of Justice. Milkman life-gripping Dilly back to the pillar. Envious in hot pursuit. He's got the Crusade rolling. He's building his damage. He's going to be maxing out at 50% increased damage towards the end of this. Kolo getting swapped to as Casca's Angels try to make a miracle swap to the healer. They catch him in the middle of the map trying to punch punish that positioning, at least somewhat of an adaptation. They managed to get the Astral Shift, potentially a swap back to him later on, could net them a kill.
Yep, that was the Incarnation and the True Shot Aura, so that's a lot of damage that they used to try to take Kolo down. Ultimately, will survive. MDS cells, Blessing and Protection cells, a lot of defensive. Thugonomics uses his Dark Soul to try to get a little bit of pressure here, spamming out the Fears, looking for a Chaos Bolt once again onto Dilly. And one thing I noticed is Milkman, he's actually playing the Knock talent, so he doesn't have the short Fear, and that's maybe one of the reasons why he doesn't want to push in, because his Fear is such a long cooldown.
All right, Kolo getting dispelled to the stun by Envious. Kolo's struggling a lot more. He used his Spiritling Totem at what point? Kolo doesn't actually have any defensive cooldowns. If they can somehow get on top of him, land a triple Fear, this might be the winning strategy to just train down the healer. Milkman's still a bit reluctant, though, to get aggressive. Chaos Bolt lobbed out. Milkman's just going to take that behind the pillar and heal that back up. Psyfoxy building up the bleeds, looking for the next stun. Kolo needs to pre-earthen this. Although with the positioning that he has right now, Dilly can't be forced to overextend. Hammer of Justice onto Milkman. He trinkets out. Doesn't want to fall behind. Kolo gets stunned in the open. He does have the pre-earthen shield totem. He should be able to easily tank this out as his entire team moves into it. And Casca's Angels, they're not even looking for crowd control. They're just going to do damage to everyone on the team. Nice knockback, removing the entire team from their earthen shield totem. Kolo now exposed. Wyvern Sting on Envious for crowd control. They're trying to lock the Rat Paladin out of the game, train down the healer. At least with this strategy, the mana is somewhat equal if they can keep this up.
Yeah, especially if Cole's playing the Vim talent. Unfortunately, his healing is going to be greatly reduced if he is under that 80% threshold, and maybe that's what Casca's Angels is looking to abuse, because this is the first time we've seen Milkman actually have a commanding mana lead. Thugonomics looking for the Chaos Bolt once again, looking for the Fears as well. As you can see, he's now positioned very far away from Kolo. Nice interrupt coming in from Dillipoo as Thugonomics gets bursted down. Unending Resolve is going to be traded out. Nice knock out of the Earthen Shield Totem as well. Very nicely done by Milkman in this matchup.
All right, Psyfoxy moving forward, landing a bash. Dilly looking for some aimed shots. Unfortunately, the waterfall coming down at a bit of an unfortunate time. Now Psyfoxy getting Hammer of Justice far away, but Milkman able to dispel. Psyfoxy jumping in bear form, trying to retreat away. Wyvern Sting getting removed. Psyfoxy still just trying to put on the aggression as Casca's Angels are relying on raw damage to carry this fight for them. They've still got a slight mana lead. They're swapping back to Thugonomics, catching him into a maim. And with this only damage strategy, it seems to be working out. Kolo gets caught into the stun. He gets Blessing of Protection to remove all those bleeds. But now Thugonomics doesn't have that available for him as they switch back. And Casca's Angels are showing signs of life.
Yeah, Kolo drops the Earthen Shield Totem to keep Thugonomics alive. Dillipoo looking to get aggressive with the True Shot Aura. You know, he's in a very defensive position here with Milkman, but able to get off the damage that he needs. Psyfoxy uses his Survival Instincts. Nice cap stun coming in from Kolo, but Kolo's running on fumes for mana. Almost going to be completely before we even move into dampening. Thugonomics still looking for the Chaos Bolts, but Psyfoxy and Dilly have been doing such a good job shutting it down in this matchup.
All right, good Wyvern Sting there onto Envious. He's going to be locked out of the game for quite some time while Kolo is in a desperation situation, trading out the Astral Shift. But prior to the incarnation of Psyfoxy, as soon as that incarnation gets pulled by Psyfoxy, it's going to be doing devastating amounts of damage. 10 seconds away from the Spirit Link of Kolo. He's trying to recover, gets bashed up. Psyfoxy, are you going to pull the Incarn cooldown? No, he's trying to bait more cooldowns before going for it. True Shot not available, though. Dilly needs to just crowd control the team and support Psyfoxy to keep him aggressive during these final potential moments with incarnation.
Yeah, Kolo actually able to stabilize his team for the most part, but that was, his healing cooldowns. Kolo's still rotting down low, still not doing great on mana. Thugonomics looking for the Chaos Bolt, lands it on Psyfoxy. Milkman deflecting, still has the Pain Suppression available as well. Incarnation's going to be up for Psyfoxy if he decides to pull the trigger on that. At some point, Casca's Angels is going to look to get super aggressive. Thugonomics now popping his Dark Soul, looking for a little bit of extra damage himself, but Milkman in a very good position to spam out the heals over and over and over.
Nice knock!
Big swap over on a Kolo now, so he gets knocked out of his Earthen Shield Totem. Dilly just teeing off with the aim shots over and over and over. Rot pressure coming in from Psyfoxy on all three members of Super Rejects.
I mean, look at the mana. It's basically going to run on fumes for both sides here momentarily. We're not even into dampening, so the game is easily going to end in the next couple of seconds. Kolo gets interrupted. He's got Spirit Link Totem, but he gets stunned up. He's relentless. He can't get out. Cross crowd control on Envious to deny the Sanctuary. Kolo in trouble. Ducks down below. Mortal Coil from Thugonomics. Chaos Bolt onto Dilly. He's in trouble. It's match point for Casca's Angels. They don't want to throw this away. They have a decent amount of momentum. They need to keep it up. Hammer of Justice on Psyfoxy. Chaos Bolt's being lobbed out. I would love to see Milkman push forward and land a Psychic Scream. Close this game out, because if they don't, now he is tapped on mana. Psyfoxy moves in. Trap on Envious. Kolo gets stunned up with no trinket. He's got all defensive cooldowns, though. He doesn't want to throw this away. Trades out the Astral Shift. That's going to allow him to recover. Psyfoxy switches targets. It's a race to the finish. Kolo's on fumes. Milkman's on fumes. Dilly's out in the open. A Chaos Bolt being channeled. Thugonomics trying to fake cast the interrupts. Trying to sneak that one through. Psyfoxy gets Hammer of Justice. Dispelled out. Knocked out of the Earthen Shield Totem. Thugonomics exposed. for 4 more seconds, but no crowd control for Kolo. Spamming out the healing waves. Both healers now completely tapped as we just enter dampening.
Yeah, Milkman could have had an opportunity to push in the Land of Fear. There was no Blessing of Sanctuary still available. He might be able to push in. Thugonomics unending resolve. Maybe too late. Dilly still looking for the aim shot. Thugonomics, it manages to duck out of line of sight. He does have the Spirit Link Totem available from Kolo if he does get out of
Light's Wrath
control. Light's Wrath going to be connecting, putting out big pressure on the Thugonomics as well as he looks for the Drain Life to keep himself up. But another nice knock coming in from Milkman as both healers are completely tapped.
The knockbacks are sick this game from Casca's Angels. It's removing all the defensive cooldowns from the Super Rejects, but still, both teams are completely tapped. It's anyone's game. Envious getting crowd controlled forever by Dilly, doing a great job. The Fear on the Trinket, good offensive play from Milkman. They need just a little bit more damage to put Thugonomics over the edge. He's dipping low. Kolo spamming out healing waves. No interrupt for that. He's going to connect to Dilly using Aspect of the Turtle. He knocks Thugonomics to the side, looking to go after Kolo. Kolo ducks behind the pillar. Earthen Shield Totem protecting him. Is there a knockback for Kolo? They need to get him out of this totem. Kolo's actually just going to jump in. He's abandoning the pillar. They're trying to go out in the open for Thugonomics to finish this game, as it's a race to the finish still at this point. I'm surprised that either team hasn't fallen with zero mana on both sides. Thugonomics pops on Ending Resolve with Soul Harvest. Gets bashed on the Chaos Bolt. Psyfoxy needs to avoid this Chaos Bolt. It's a big one. Chaos Bolt connects, gets absorbed by the shields from Milkman, preempting that damage with Pain Suppression. Psyfoxy trying to lead the charge, but Crusade is up. It could be a risky time for Psyfoxy to push on match point.
Yeah, Envious getting a little bit low as well. Milkman in a good position to keep his team alive. Powered Barry gets dropped out to stop some of this damage, but Dilly low! No Aspect of the Turtle available!
Whoa.
It looks like Thugonomics looking for the damage, but a nice life group going to keep him alive for now. Nicely done by Milkman, but now Psyfoxy gets caught into the Hammer of Justice. He trinkets out, Survival Instinct. Thugonomics looking to close out this game, but he gets knocked away. Milkman has been on fire in this matchup with that talent choice. Dilly forced defensive, though, and this is not a position you want to be in as Casca's Angels, as the Jungle Cleave. Envious charging in. He still has that bubble to fall back on. You can see Psyfoxy looking for the damage on a Thugonomics, but this is super good for Super Rejects. Kolo just needs to be able to survive a little bit longer.
I mean, at this point, whose game is it? Thugonomics setting up for a kill. Double Mortal Coil, Chaos Bolt, Blood of Silence, Full Fear secured onto Milkman. Unfortunately, breaking to some damage. Psyfoxy's dangerously low. Milkman triggers out of the Hammer of the Justice. It's danger time right now for both teams. Thugonomics trying to stay afloat with the Unending Resolve, but it's now over. Ferocious Bite, Earthen Shield Totem denies the kill. Thugonomics, if he gets knocked out of this Earthen Shield Totem, will explode. Chaos Bolt's being casted. Psyfoxy goes into Bear. He gets knocked out of the totem. Dilly trying to set up. Milkman moving forward. Offensive Penance. He just needs a little bit more damage to end this. Bursting Shot on Kolo. Dilly lands a trap. Where's the Imp Dispel? Imp Dispel instantly by Thugonomics. Blessing of Protection, though, protects Thugonomics. Now Milkman is pushed forward. He's caught into a Hammer of Justice. Envious gets peeled away. I'd almost like to see Envious just Divine Shield to get out of this crowd control and end the game. I understand he doesn't want to throw it. Nice Cap Totem from Kolo. Nice Hex from Kolo. Triple crowd control from one player, despite being trained down the entire game, opens up a win condition and takes it 3-0. Yeah.